I will introduce buildingSMART Finland update actually directly from our webpage because we didn't want to make a PowerPoint. I will show very shortly about our situation. We have a buildingSMART.fi webpage, and you can choose both Finnish or English. This time I choose English. I think it's a little bit easier for you guys. About us, buildingSMART Finland is a network, and 2 years ago we were still like special committee of Building Information Foundation, under Building Information Foundation, and a few years ago we started a little bit reconstruction project for buildingSMART Finland, and the aim of that that construction project is to make more professional organization. Before we only had a half-time one person working half-time for BSF, no professional office, and the network was quite voluntary network. A few years ago we decided we have to change this a little bit, make it more professional. Also our development projects were more very segmented. One project was started for something, and we decided that the whole industry needs a bigger development project for BIM in Finland. So we actually made buildingSMART Finland, was born again under a company called Building Information Model. It's still wholly owned by Building Information Foundation, so it's a public foundation only, this Building Information Model LTD, but our buildingSMART Finland is now independent organization working under this one. It's open for all industry members. Some figures here, we have worked or already 25 years under this buildingSMART or previous, maybe the name was a little bit different earlier. We have four industry or four rooms, as maybe you call them. We have over 120 member organizations. We have now six projects, development projects starting or going on, and we are open for everybody. About us, we have four rooms. We have a building room, infrastructure room, city planning room, and knowledge and change management room. And under those rooms, we have actually building and infrastructure have some sub-rooms. I will show it actually from here. Our steering committee is here. Annina is CEO, working for 100% for buildingSMART Finland, making the orchestra to really kick. I'm not working for buildingSMART Finland. I'm working for FTIA. I'm a chair of BS Finland. And then we have office. Annina has two office members, Mary and Etta, half-time, half-day both project coordinator and network coordinator. Then our industry chairs, our room chairs are here. Heidi is leading infrastructure room, Marko is building room, Jarkko city planning room, and Timo knowledge and change management room. And under infra room, there is still four under room, water supply room, standardization room, development room, and infrastructure clients group room. And in building room, there is also building clients group and contractors group and building services group. You might know some persons, for example, Tina, you everybody know. Then we have some consulting expertised members like Tina and Riikka in our steering group. Little bit more about we reorganized 2 years ago. We started last year 2021. We very much made our new rules of working. We, for example, made how do we work document, where is how this network is really working. It was a quite a lot big work for the organization who has already been working 20 years with not so strict rules, strict working periods. We wanted that for example, rooms has been very independent, making very own projects without talking to other rooms. And we wanted that now this buildingSMART Finland network would work much more better to one direction. So we have made this kind of, we have also made lots of development. This web page was also developed last year. We have here also, as you can see here, discussion forums. There is some file sharing systems in this network. So this network is wholly working in this web page. I had just a second. Our members, here are our members. I said about 120 members. Members, you might recognize some of the companies, but we have public and private client organizations, for example, like FTIA, Senate properties from the state, quite many cities, consultant companies, construction companies, quite many software companies related to the BIM or construction industry. We have universities, we have a different kind of companies. If you want to join our members, I will show just, you can join from here, filling these, and this is the fees 2022. So actually, if I understood right from these calls, that our fees are actually quite slow compared to many other chapters. This year, we actually updated those prices for next year, 15%, mostly because of inflation. Everybody knows that inflation is going up. Also that we haven't been updating those fees for a few years. Even we have invested quite a lot for this renewing this network last years. So these industry rooms make lots of collaboration inside them, between them, and one big thing 2 years ago, we also wanted to collect some money and make the development of BSI much more professional. We launched this kind of RYTV project program. If you come to the InfraBIM Open, there is a presentation of this by Annina and Mary, our project coordinator. But this RYTV is shortening from Rakennetun ympäristön tietomallivaatimukset, Information Model Requirements for Built Environment in Finnish. And the goal of this project is collect money from the industry, and we have a target in 2025 to go to the one big goal to make BIM even better in Finland. We have here is the program timeline. We launched this program January 2022. We set the goals, framework goals. We started to collect money for this development last spring. We have now started the first project. Our first funding collection round was quite efficient if you compare that there is a high inflation, a war in Ukraine, very, very uncertain times this time for the industry, especially for the construction industry. We have started, we have collected quite much money already for this one. And our goal is 2025, when we want our big goal to be fulfilled, but we go there very scrum. When we collect money, we have a news project starting, we update the goal a little bit, and but the idea is that now we have collected for all those industries, building, infrastructure, city client, city, and change management. We have collected funds for all of those four sessions. Just one more, and actually I think here is even our goal for first funding round is for 500,000 euros. We have collected now almost 300,000 euros and started the first project this autumn. Rasso, you have your hand up.
Yes, a question. Is this are you just asking for money, or is this money focused for on specific projects?
We made a project plan, and there was five elements. There is the common element for common BIM framework. Then there is a element for building development, element for infrastructure, element for city planning, and element for change and management. And we sent a letter for all the organizations that we want funding from you, and then the organizations can say for which element they want to fund. For example, my own organization, Finnish Transport Infrastructure Agency, we are not interested for the buildings. we are just infrastructure, and the Senat properties are not interested for infrastructure. They put all funding to the buildings and common framework and the change management. And actually the whole project is also living how much funding we get for every element, and it's going like that all the time.
Right, thank you.
Yeah. So our goal in Change 2020 was to make this organization more professional and get funding for our development. I think we are on the way for that one, but still much to do. So I will still have here latest. You can see also events calendar. I have to raise these other events are quite finished, but I have to raise up InfraBIM Open. InfraBIM Open is now coming in the end of January in Tampere. We have published now the program for this one. We have already sold almost 300 tickets for this event, and there is about 600 tickets altogether. So if you want to be there, be fast. We have a very good program this year. We have keynotes from the Bane Nor, from Norwegian railway organization, Stine Unrum, executive vice president of infrastructure construction division. And also other keynote is from Japan, Nobuyoshi Yabugi from Osaka University. And we also have published the whole program. Now I will just raise this up. There is very interesting presentations from different sides of the infrastructure sector. You can see here, for example, public owners session, life cycle data session, bridge design session, sustainability session. There is a BIM and GIS session. For example, this is very interesting session where there is a session where Leo Van Berlo is talking about BSDD, and then there is a Finnish case study from BSDD straight after that one. And in the end also, Leif Granholm, Tina Pertula are like close in the session. So InfraBIM Open is ready and waiting for you guys to join. So, ladies and gentlemen, this was shortly about Finnish chapter and buildingSMART Finland. Any questions?